Hello, my friends. Today I am in Mandalay, very important city in Myanmar. This city is 1 hour by flight from Yangon. The cost of the flight is $100-$150. When you arrive at the airport, go to the taxi counter, you can reach the city with 15,000 riyal, that is almost $10. You can also use the application Grab everywhere, and I strongly suggest you to install and use this application. If you don't have too much money, you can reach Mandalay by bus from Yangon. It's around 8-9 hours and the cost is around $10-$12. Guys, if you come here, take an accommodation close to the Royal Palace, that is this one that I am going to visit. As you can see, I have the visitor badge. They took my passport at the reception. You have to bring the original one. The cost to enter is 10,000 riyal. So let's start with point number one, the Royal Palace. The Royal Palace is one of the main touristic attractions in Mandalay. Locals like taking wedding pictures inside. This palace is the last of the Burmese monarchy. It was founded in 1859 and was almost completely destroyed during the Second World War. The palace was rebuilt with modern materials in 1990. My friends, the dress code is required. Cover your shoulders and legs, but at least you can walk with your shoes. The palace is open daily from 7:30 in the morning until 4:30 in the afternoon, and the entrance is around $7. Let's go! Once that you pay the ticket and you leave your passport, you have to walk 1 kilometer to reach the palace entrance, luckily with shoes. The ticket seems to be valid for 5 days, so don't trash it. I'm walking since 1 hour and now I discovered that I took the wrong path. Guys, the entrance is right in front of the ticket office. Is a little bit a labyrinth here. The entrance is here. I was confused because there are also cars entering. They will try to offer you motorbike taxi everywhere, but just walk is good for the health. That's a quite relaxing place that you can visit in around 1 hour if you take the good path, not like me, otherwise you will take half a day. Let's move to the next destination, guys. Today I will bring you to the Mandalay Hill, the main attraction of Mandalay. This hill is 224 meters high, and the legend say that Lord Buddha was on top of this hill, and he told that one day a big city will be built below the hill. This city was Mandalay, so the legend was true. There are several steps to climb, always without shoes, to reach the top. The best time is sunset and sunrise, and this walk takes half an hour, more or less. I think I took the wrong direction. I can just see trees. I cannot see any view. But let's do something. And now, let's fly, my friends. I had to stop the flight, my friends. It's raining like crazy. Whoa. I am back to the Mandalay Hill. I think yesterday, with the bad weather, I didn't reach the top. I took some wrong path. Let's try again. There are two possible ways. One and two. I think yesterday I took the other one. Now I will try this one. Oh, I am burning today. Finally, I found this other route. Let's see. You have to pay 1,000 kyats to enter in this area, and the view is very beautiful. The funny thing is that you can reach this point via tuk-tuk, then you take the lift and you are directly to the top, and you can avoid all these steps and be very fast. Oh, I didn't know that. The view here was very nice, and now I have to run to see the Ubein Bridge. Let's go! I forgot my drone at home. Now I took it. It's time to grab a tuk-tuk and reach the Ubein Bridge. Let's try to catch the sunset. The Ubein Bridge is the longest wood-made walkable bridge in the world. You will need to drive almost for 10 kilometers to reach this point. As I told, grab a tuk-tuk. Quite overcrowded. And now, let's try to fly. That's an overcrowded spot, but definitely a must see. So, nightlife, my friends. The nightlife in Mandalay is equal to zero, but this is the punishment for my lifestyle. So, guys, I'm walking alone in the night. No problem here, everything is safe. I will just go to some place to drink some beer and eat some good food. With $5.50, I got chicken with cashews in onion sauce, plus eggs, fries, rice, 2 pints of very good Myanmar craft beer and nuts. That's good stuff, my friends. Are you saborito? My friends, now I will show you a nice ice cream place. The Nilo ice cream bar. I will grab a tuk-tuk and I will reach this place. Let's try the strawberry dessert. Good stuff, guys. So, my friends, I will say that a couple of nights in Mandalay are enough. You can also stay some more days if you want to do some tour outside the city. I will write in the video description some places that you can visit here around and you can explore them. So tomorrow I will move to visit the giant Buddha in Mondia. See you next time.